Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? It has been a significant amount of time since I have been able to make a video for you fine gentlemen, and I usually have pretty good excuses on why it's difficult for me to make a video, but I don't think I could come up with a better excuse than Hurricane Sandy. Happened recently, it was a double hurricane. I don't know if you heard, newscasters were calling it a Frankenstorm because they need to come up with a buzzword for everything. It didn't even look like Frankenstein, which, I mean, defamation of character on that one. It was just wind, and it was pretty bad wind. Last year, we did have Hurricane Irene, which wasn't so bad. I'm pretty sure it knocked over a chair. Some dude just picked the chair back up, and everything was fine. So I didn't really think too much of Hurricane Sandy going in, because Hurricane Irene, which knocked over a chair, was built up so much. You just kept hearing, the wind is coming. It was kind of like Game of Thrones, where you just nonstop, you hear, winter is coming. And then two seasons later, I haven't even seen a snowflake yet. Come on. So Hurricane Sandy coming down the road, it's just, people are overreacting again, but it actually did end up knocking around quite a bit more significant things. For example, in the general area around here, there were boats everywhere, just stacks of boats. I think maybe it had to have been at least 5 sailboats stacked on top of each other in one big pile, and then around that is just a field of boats that got pushed whichever way. Hurricane Sandy set them free to do whatever they would want to do without masters, so just boats everywhere. Just boats everywhere. That's my summary of Hurricane Sandy. Just boats everywhere. There was a train bridge nearby here where, you know, it's high enough that boats can go underneath it. It wasn't a very high bridge, but there were boats stuck on top of it. Just boats everywhere. Can I just leave it at that? I'm sure by now it's been quite a while since it actually happened. If you've looked into it at all, you've seen pictures, you know what the deal is. It's really bad down the shore, which is sad. In places like Seaside, I'm sure we're being punished for, like, the Jersey Shore TV show. It's a little bit too late for that, but I know there have been bigger disasters around the world, more significant than this one, but to see it done to a place where you've grown up your entire life, it's a little bit different. It feels a little bit more real, because I have been to the Seaside Boardwalk so many times, and now it's completely ripped up and half of, like, the pier is in the water and the roller coaster. It looks kind of cool that the roller coaster is just, you know, standing up in the ocean. But nonetheless, that's pretty crazy. That kind of stuff doesn't actually happen around here. That boardwalk has existed since, I don't know, just always. I was born and it was there. So my best wishes to anybody who was affected and has it worse than I do, because I'm fine. The whole, my general domicile area, nothing actually happened. This whole neighborhood, in fact, like, nothing here, there's no phone poles knocked over, there is nothing. We were just without power for 8.5 days. 8.5 days. It's like when you're 8 years old, and you're almost 9, so you gotta tell everyone that you're 8.5, because you want everyone to understand how excited you are about your 9th birthday! It's kinda like that. I want you to acknowledge that there was a half a day in there without power, because that's pretty significant stuff. Power being out that long kind of sucked, and it's not just because, like, oh no, I can't use my computer! I missed 2 episodes of Dexter, that is unacceptable. I am gonna catch up on that after this video, but it wasn't just that, everywhere was affected by this, so there was, like, almost no food here. If you wanted to go out into the world to get food, everywhere is closed because nowhere has power. And more than anything, it got really cold after the hurricane. There's no heat. You're bored, you can't go out anywhere once again and do things because everywhere's out of power, and you can't just go outside and do outside activities. Shut up with that. That's crazy talk. But the main thing here, the most important thing to keep in mind, is that the power going out was not a surprise. It wasn't a big deal. During Hurricane Irene, the power went out for a day. It's nothing out of the ordinary, so I just figure, you know, this is gonna last 2 days maximum. I'm just gonna sit here and endure it. It's gonna be fine. It's not like I need to make a whole preparation and plan for the power to be out for 8.5 days, because I don't know that's gonna happen. My neighborhood, once again, looks fine. It doesn't look like the power should be out that long. I heard some wind outside. I pretty much slept through the entire storm, so I didn't really think it was that big of a deal. But by day 5 without power, I began to lose all hope. I still have that feeling within me that any moment the power is going to be turned back on. It has been 5 days without any sign of electricity anywhere. So of course, you know, it's gonna be any moment. Just hang on there for a few more seconds. It's, you know, I'm just sticking with my plan. That is gonna be no problem, and I'll just stick it through this. And this entire time, every day, I've been listening to the radio because it feels like there's someone there talking to me. And finally, somebody comes on the radio, and he says in a deep and very serious voice, "I would like to talk to everybody today about a topic that is very serious. Cabin fever." And at the exact moment he said cabin fever, I knew deep within my soul that he had just given it to me, that I wasn't feeling insane or bored or anything before, but then he said cabin fever, and then all of a sudden all I can think about is freaking cabins. And cabin fever is not a joke, I will have you know. Cabin fever is the entire premise on the movie The Shining. Cabin fever would have been a better name for the movie Friday the 13th. Cabin fever sounds like something R.L. Stine would write, and you'd get to choose your own fate and jump to the page and you die every time and it's always your fault and it's really horrible. But it's okay, everybody. He came on the radio specifically to tell people how to alleviate the symptoms of cabin fever. So now that he's given it to me, he's about to tell me how I can fix this problem. And he begins to explain, if you're feeling these symptoms, if you feel like you may have cabin fever, just go outside, take a walk. It doesn't even matter if it's dark out. You need to get outside and walk around, and you can fantasize while you're doing that. Hold on a second. Your solution to cabin fever is to go around and walk outside in the dark. First point, in the dark. Nobody has power anywhere near here. It is completely dark outside because no one has electricity. And if I go walk around in circles in the dark outside and fantasize, what do you think I'm gonna fantasize about? I'm gonna freaking think, wouldn't it be cool if I had power at my house and I wouldn't have to walk around in the dark? That's what I'm gonna fantasize about, and I'm finally gonna go home, try and turn on the power when I get there. It's not gonna turn on. I'm gonna freak out and just kill somebody.